Thank you. Right. Good afternoon, everyone.
WGN Newsroom. This is WGN News Now.
Hello, I am Larry Hawley. Welcome to WGN News Now as we bring you live coverage of Chicago Fire FC's introductory news conference. This will be for Jairo Torres, the team's young designated player, whom they officially completed a transaction with Liga MX club Atlas FC to acquire back in February. Now Torres is in Chicago, expected to make his debut within the next 2 weeks. That news conference is happening right now in downtown Chicago. Let's bring you there right now as Jairo Torres is being introduced by Chicago Fire FC.
Good addition to the greater Chicago community. Our club has historically always have had good Mexican players, and we're excited to have Jairo following in the footsteps of those great players. Jairo has joined us now in a very important stage of the season, and we're all looking forward to see him playing at Soldier Field live on May 14th. So again, I'd like to say a big thank you to our owner Joe Mansueto. With his continued belief and his investments throughout the entire club, he made it happen that we were able to sign Jairo. Thank you.
Wonderful. Thanks, Ezra.
Also, I'd like to thank all of you guys for taking some time out to be here today, as well as those of you on Zoom and live stream. You know, a player like Jairo, he's someone that could make a coach's life a lot easier, take away some of your sleepless nights. And he's just a very good player, great player with good technical ability, especially on 1v1 situations, something that, you know, we need on this team. I think he's going to help us going forward in the attack, and we're very, very, very happy to have him here. I think the fans are going to enjoy watching him play week in and week out. And like I said, he's a player that can really change the fate of a team. So we're very, very happy to have him and look forward to seeing great things from him on the pitch.
All right, thanks, Ezra. And before we get to Jairo, just a reminder that Elizabeth Sanchez, our translation expert, is here and will provide translation for Jairo from Spanish to English throughout the press conference today. So with that, Jairo, I'll turn it over to you.
Hola para todos. Yo la verdad estoy muy, muy feliz y muy entusiasmado de formar parte de Chicago Fire, porque estoy muy agradecido con la directiva, con el entrenador, porque me esperaron, ¿no?, este tiempo para poder llegar acá. Y la verdad, muy, muy feliz, muy contento por poder estar en esta ciudad. Más aparte porque es un equipo importante, ¿no? Un equipo importante, de los primeros de la MLS cuando empezó la liga. Y entusiasmado, muy, muy feliz de ya poder jugar aquí en el equipo. Y mis compañeros me recibieron muy bien, y aprender, ¿no? Aprender de ellos y aquí adaptarme a la ciudad. Muchas gracias.
Hello. Thank you all for being here. I'm just really, really happy to be here. I'm very excited to finally be able to be a part of the Chicago Fire. I'm also really grateful with the coaching staff and with all of the directors in the club because they waited for me to get here. And I'm really happy to finally be able to come here and help the team out. And especially because the Chicago Fire is such an important team. It's one of the first teams to join MLS when the league started. And I'm very excited to finally be here in the city and to be able to play with all my teammates. And my teammates received me in the best way possible. Everyone was really kind, and I'm ready. I can't wait to start learning from them and to adapt to this city.
Wonderful. Thanks, gentlemen. We'll open it up to questions in the room and on Zoom as well. Just a reminder for those on Zoom, to use the raise hand icon if you'd like to ask a question. All right, so we'll start here in the room. For any questions, just give me a little wave if you'd like to go. We'll start here with Alex first, and then we'll go to Liz Jimenez next. Go ahead, Alex.
¿Qué te atrae de la ciudad de Chicago, el Fire, y la oportunidad de venir a jugar aquí en Estados Unidos y MLS?
Es una liga que está creciendo mucho, ¿no? Es una liga muy atractiva. Últimamente han salido muchos jugadores de Europa, de aquí para Europa, y la verdad eso también me atrae de la liga porque también es el sueño de todos, ¿no? Poder ir a Europa, y el proyecto que me mostraron aquí fue el que me gustó porque ese es el concepto que tenemos todo y esperemos llegar a eso.
This league is a league that's been growing for many, many years. It's very attractive, and it's really exciting to be able to come here because a lot of players that have been coming here with the growth of the league have also moved on to play in Europe. And at the end of the day, that's everyone's dream, right? To be able to go to Europe. So it was really attractive for me, and the project that they showed me when they presented it to me was also one that I really liked and really enjoyed, and hopefully we'll be able to put it through and see it through to the end.
All right, we'll go to Liz next. And just a reminder, if you could please state who your question is directed towards for each of the three gentlemen on the stage. Go ahead, Liz.
Hola, Jairo. Hola. Liz Jimenez de la Ley 107.9, Spanish Broadcasting System. Bienvenido. Bienvenido a Chicago. Sé que hay mucha gente aquí de Guadalajara que ya te han dado la bienvenida a través de tus redes sociales. Y bueno, pues obviamente eres un joven talento que tiene mucho, mucho que dar en esta ciudad. Me gustaría saber si, bueno, han pasado por aquí jugadores que tú conoces del calibre de Cuauhtémoc Blanco, de Pavel Pardo, de Jorge Campos. ¿Alguno de ellos te habló? ¿Has tenido contacto con algunos de ellos para saber a dónde estás parado, a dónde venías, para que tú tomaras esa decisión de decir, voy al Chicago Fire?
Hola, Liz. Sí, aquí hubo jugadores mexicanos muy importantes para nuestra nación. Y también la gente, ¿no? La gente, hay mucha gente mexicana, mucha paisanos. Y la verdad feliz, ¿no? Feliz por eso también porque me han arropado muy bien, me han recibido bien, muchos mensajes de afecto y estoy muy agradecido con ello. Y la verdad, sí me hicieron un video Jorge Campos y Pavel explicándome, diciéndome que es un equipo muy bueno, muy grande, y la verdad también agradecerles a ellos por sus palabras.
Cuauhtémoc, ¿no? ¿No hubo contacto con el Temoc?
No, con Cuau no hubo.
You are coming to a city that has seen, to a club that has seen a lot of great Mexican players, and there are a lot of people here from Guadalajara who've already been congratulating you on your social media. But there have been players like Cuauhtémoc Blanco, Pavel Pardo, Jorge Campos. Did anyone reach out to you? Have you spoken with any of them for them to talk about this club and see, you know, what you were thinking that made you decide to sign here? Yes, I know that there are a lot of Mexican players that have gone through this club, players that are very important for us as a nation, and players like Cuauhtémoc and Pavel. And I know that also the people have been great. There are a lot of Mexicans and a lot of compatriots. And I've been really happy and grateful for all of their messages on social media. They've received me really well. And yeah, they made a video for me, Jorge Campos and Pavel Pardo. They explained to me the importance of this club and what a great club and city it is. So I'm really grateful to them for having done that.
Great, thanks. We'll go next to Hector here in the front.
Hola, Héctor Lozano de Telemundo Chicago. Bienvenido, Jairo, a nuestra ciudad. Bienvenido al equipo. Yo sé que dejas al actual campeón del fútbol mexicano, a Rojinegros del Atlas, y ahora están en Liguilla. ¿Qué tan difícil fue para ti? Ya sabías que estaba el trato hecho con el Chicago Fire. ¿Qué tan difícil fue para ti, pues, obviamente, viajar a Chicago y llegar al equipo ya en la parte final de la temporada y en México?
Sí, la verdad, fue algo que se habló, ¿no? Algo que se habló desde el principio. Esa era la posibilidad para poder venir para acá. Y, pues, sí, Sí, es un poco triste, pero yo lo dije en una entrevista ya en Guadalajara. Dije que yo iba a estar concentrado en el equipo Atlas hasta el 30 de abril y el 1 de mayo mi cabeza iba a estar en Chicago, ¿no? Porque es un nuevo reto para mí y un nuevo paso. Y siempre voy a estar también agradecido con mis compañeros y con el club. Voy a seguir siguiéndolos, alentándolos, pero mi mente y mi cuerpo ahora está acá y tengo que estar concentrado acá en Chicago y dar mi mayor esfuerzo acá.
You left an Atlas team that was champion last season, and now they're in playoffs and on the verge of potentially another championship. How difficult for you was it to leave the team in those circumstances? Yeah, we had talked about it from the very beginning that it was a possibility, and it was one of the terms for me to be able to come here. So it was a little bit sad for me to leave them like that, but I had already mentioned it in an interview in Guadalajara that I said I was completely concentrated and focused with Atlas until April 30th, and beginning May 1st, I was going to be completely focused on Chicago Fire. And it's a new challenge for me, so I'm always going to be grateful with all of my teammates and with the club, and I'm going to be following them and cheering them on from here. But my body and my mind are here in Chicago. I'm completely concentrated here, and I'm going to do my best here.
Jeremy?
Hi. Hi, Ro. Jeremy McCool, Chicago Tribune. First of all, welcome to Chicago. A lot's going to be expected of you taking on a bigger role on this team, both as a leader on the pitch and also off the pitch. How prepared are you to take that role at such a young age?
Se espera mucho de ti como líder dentro y fuera del campo en este equipo. Eres un jugador joven. ¿Qué tan preparado estás para ese rol, ese tipo de responsabilidad?
Creo que he madurado mucho en Atlas. El equipo que me tocó me ayudó mucho y la verdad yo sé que se tienen muchas expectativas hacia mí y voy a tratar de tomar ese rol, ¿no? Ese rol que por algo vengo acá, por algo di este paso tan importante en mi carrera para poder tomar el rol de ser líder dentro y fuera de la cancha. Y dar mi mayor esfuerzo acá siempre y ser agradecido también con el club.
I think that I matured a lot in Atlas. The team that I was on really helped me to grow and to mature into a better player. And yeah, in reality, I knew that coming in, there were a lot of expectations on me, but I'm gonna try to take on that role to be a leader always on and off the field. I mean, there's a reason that I came here. So I'm gonna give everything that I have to be a role model, to be on and off the field, be completely concentrated, and do my best here.
All right, we'll take some from Zoom. We'll go next to Brian Sandalo. Go ahead, Brian.
For Sebastian. This is Brian Sandalo with Chicago Sun-Times. There's been some reports about you guys talking to Chris Mueller about bringing him in. What can you say about those reports, and is there any accuracy to them, and are you expecting that to get across the line?
Hi, Brian. Yeah, we are aware of the reports. We know Chris Mueller very well from his time in the league. We know as he's grew up in the Chicago area. At this moment, I don't want to get into detail too much. However, we might come back and share with more news in the upcoming days.
Great. All right, we'll go next to Pat McCraney from Chicago Sports. Pat, go ahead.
Hey Ezra, it seems like we've been putting, like media, fans, been putting a lot of pressure and expectations on Jairo. You got to wait until Jairo gets here. Jairo's going to help unlock this offense. How do you, as his coach, help him manage those expectations while still trying to get the most out of them?
Well, I mean, he has the ability to do that and to really change this team as far as our attacking prowess. But we understand that, you know, when a player joins a new league, sometimes it takes a while for him to, you know, get used to, you know, the traveling, the style of play and stuff like that. So the pressure is not being put on by us as a team. I'm sure the fans, you know, are happy to have him here. We're very, very happy to have him here, but we're also realistic that, and we know that, you know, although he has such exceptional qualities that, you know, there might be some, it might take a while before he gets, you know, used to the just the league. You know, sometimes it happens right away for foreign players. Sometimes it takes him a while, and hopefully it happens sooner for us rather than later. But no pressure would be directly put on him from us. We do have a lot of good players on the team already, and he will complement us really, really well with his technical ability and his 1v1 individual skills that I mentioned earlier.
Paul?
Thank you. Paul Tenorio from The Athletic. I have questions for both Jairo and Sebastian as well. Jairo, ¿dónde prefieres jugar? ¿Como extremo o volante interior mixto? Y Sebastian, with these additions, potentially Chris Mueller in a couple days and Jairo today, how do you look at the roster build now, and how does it change maybe the way you think about the summer window and areas and places that you want to add or reinforce the team? Thank you.
La verdad, a mí me lo dijo un entrenador que soy un jugador muy versátil, que por eso los jugadores son más vistos, ¿no? Porque pueden ocupar varias posiciones, y yo en cualquiera que me pongan voy a rendir de la mejor manera.
Where do you prefer to play? Do you prefer to play on the wing or more as like an attacking winger? In truth, a coach once told me that I am a player that is very, very versatile, and that's how players get seen more when they're able to play everywhere. So I'm going to play wherever I'm needed, and wherever they put me, I'm going to do my best wherever I am on the field.
Great.
Paul, hi. Well, just going a bit backwards, when we started to build the team in beginning of the season, for us it was very important that we give us a few options, that we have additions possible during the first transfer window, but also have an opportunity to add one or the other player in the second window. So now with Jairo coming in, potential another player coming in, this is exactly how we planned it out, and Ezra was always, and the coaching staff, they were always involved with that. So we're trying to build something steady, but also we'd like to see the development also in the side where we need some more players, and we still have an opportunity to add another player in the next transfer window.
All right, we'll go on the front here to Noé.
Hola Jairo, Noé Brito de TUDN Radio Chicago. Primero, bienvenida a la ciudad, gracias, al equipo. Y preguntarte en lo personal, conociendo la historia del Atlas y los canteranos, sabiendo la inmensa cantidad de jugadores que ha producido, ¿cómo te sientes tú en ser de los primeros que sale del club sabiendo que ganaste el campeón? Algo que muchos trataron pero nunca pudieron conseguir.
Sí. La verdad, me voy contento y muy feliz de mi club, porque pues como canterano es algo que sueñas, ¿no? Que sueñas allá, ser campeón, pero también para abrirle las puertas, ¿no? A más compañeros de allá para esta liga o para otra, pero también ya concentrado acá y también para poder conseguir títulos aquí en Chicago.
First of all, welcome to the club and welcome to the city. And the personal level, you're one of the players from the Atlas Academy, one of the few players. They have a great academy system, but you're one of the few players who was actually able to go through the system and come out as a champion. How do you feel about that, about being able to go through a system and be a champion? I'm very happy. I'm very happy to with my club, very happy to have been able to be a champion. It's something that you always dream of as you're going through the academy, to be a champion with your club, and also because it's able to open doors for other players, for my teammates to come to this league and maybe to potentially to other leagues. But now I'm focused here, I'm concentrated on here, and focused on bringing titles and championships to Chicago.
Thanks, E. We'll go back to Zoom, this time to Tom Bogert from MLSsoccer.com. Excuse me. Tom, go ahead.
Thanks, David. Hey, guys. Thanks for taking the time. This one's for Ezra. With Jairo joining the attack, how does this kind of change the dynamic, change the complexion of this attack, and how does his qualities align with Jaron Shaqiri and Casper Jabilko and the rest of the high-level kind of attackers in this team?
Well, one of the issues we're having right now in the attacking end of things is, one, getting into the final third, and two, once we're there, right now the quality hasn't been there. So, with Jairo and his abilities, I think he will complement Shaq really well, because one of two ways getting behind defenses. You either do it with a knife in through ball, that we all know that Shaqiri is capable of doing. Now we have someone else who can be in the end of that, those passes. And also on a 1v1, taking defenders on 1v1, which Jairo is very, very capable of doing. So he adds that dimension for us with the guys that we currently have to be able to get behind defenses, which is what we're having a little issues with right now. I think we defend really well, but then our transition from defense to offense, we're not getting from the mid third into the final third as efficiently as we need to. And then once we get there, the quality hasn't really been there. So he helps us in that aspect. So we're looking forward to great things and a better, more balanced team.
Okay, we'll go here, second row.
Hola, Jairo, ¿cómo estás?
Hola, muy bien.
Buenas tardes, soy Roberto Ávila de la revista Magazine in Chicago. Exclusiva. Primero te doy la bienvenida.
Gracias.
Gracias por venir aquí a Chicago. Estamos muy contentos de tenernos nosotros como hispanos. Te quería hacer una comparación con la Liga Mexicana a la Liga de aquí de la MLS. Sabemos que tú eres un jugador talentoso, has jugado en Atlas, estuviste en la selección de sub-17, eres una promesa joven. ¿Qué es lo que esperas, la comparación de lo que es la Liga Mexicana con la Liga MLS? ¿Qué es lo que tú piensas? ¿Si has visto videos? ¿Si ya te has informado para ver cómo es lo que va a ser tu desarrollo como futbolista?
Sí, no. Llego siguiendo la liga ya un tiempo para acá. La verdad, se está volviendo muy competitiva la liga de aquí de Estados Unidos. Ahí lo tienen en Conca Champions, está la final contra Pumas. Es una liga muy buena, muy, muy atractiva, igual la Liga MX, ¿no? Pero lo que me trae para acá es eso, ¿no? También de poder dar un brinco en mi carrera grande y de aquí que me voltean a ver a otros lados, ¿no? Es un sueño para mí poder irme para Europa igual, pero primero tengo que dar un gran desempeño aquí en Chicago para poder dar ese paso. Gracias.
What are your expectations comparing Liga MX with MLS? Have you watched the league? Have you seen video? What are you expecting? I've been following this league for a while now. I know that it's becoming very, very competitive. You see it there in the CONCACAF Champions League final with the final against Pumas. It's a very attractive, very strong league, just like Liga MX. And what made me want to come here is because it's a big step. It's a big jump in my career. And from here, maybe someone can see me and I can go elsewhere, somewhere else. But in order for me to be able to move on and go anywhere else, I have to do my best and have a really good development and play a really good role here in Chicago.
Great. We'll go back to Zoom, this time to Omar Ramos. Omar, go ahead. Your line is open. Omar, are you still with us?
Yes, I'm here. Sorry about that. I forgot to push the unmute button. That'll help. Okay, cool. So I have two questions for Jairo and also for Ezra. Jairo, primero, de nuevo, bienvenido a la ciudad de Chicago, hermano. Qué bueno que estás aquí. Ya muchos de los colegas de los medios de comunicación hicieron preguntas muy buenas. Yo te quiero preguntar sobre tu número. Sé que tienes que cambiar el número del Atlas. Y creo que te dieron el número 7. ¿Significa algo ese número para ti? And also for Ezra, I know that you have an important game this Saturday. Is there a chance that Jairo gets some minutes in there, or are we going to have to wait until the 14th to see him with
the jersey on versus FC Cincinnati?
Thank you. La verdad, yo quería el número 20, pero no estaba disponible. Así que también me gusta el 7, porque el 7 lo tuve en todas mis selecciones menores. Y por eso fue la decisión también de tomar el número 7.
I wanted to ask you about your number. You have to change numbers from Atlas, and now you're going to have number 7. Does that mean anything for you? What was it like to change? The truth is, I wanted number 20, but I also like number 7 because that's the number I had during my whole youth national team career. So I also like number 7.
Easy.
And before I answer mine, is there anyone from Atlanta listening to this? No, seriously, you know, he's here to play. And, you know, we'll see how, you know, he's come off. He just played on the weekend. He's traveled, you know, he has to do his medicals and all and stuff like that. So we'll see how that goes. But the plan is to give him some minutes on Saturday. So be ready.
All right, we'll stick with Zoom. Daniel Schwartzman, your line is open.
Thank you. Jairo, hola, bienvenido a la MLS. ¿Has tenido tiempo de ver los partidos del Fire en semanas recientes? Y si sí, ¿qué diagnóstico haces del equipo? ¿Qué observaciones? ¿Qué jugadores destacas quizá? ¿Y ya tuviste o no algún previo contacto con la plantilla y cómo te han recibido? Gracias.
Hola. Sí, ¿no? Desde que fiché acá he estado al pendiente de los juegos de Chicago, de los marcadores, de todo eso. Y pues yo pues destaco a Sheridan, ¿no? Es un jugador excepcional, nivel mundial, y pero pues todos mis compañeros, ¿no? Mis compañeros tienen una calidad muy muy grande. Simplemente pues ha habido ahí expulsiones y esas cosas que han favorecido el marcador, perdón. Pero de ahí el más, yo veo un equipo muy competitivo y vengo a competir también para ganarme mi puesto aquí.
Have you been watching the Fire play? Have you had a chance between Atlas games to watch the team? And what do you think? Is there any player that stands out to you? What do you think about the team in general? Yeah, ever since I signed, I've been watching the team and following along, watching games, checking scores. Player that stands out is, I guess, Sheridan. He's an exceptional player, World Cup player, world class. And really all of my teammates have great quality. They're great players. And maybe recently in the games there have been some ejections and things that maybe haven't favored the team very well. But I think it's going to be a great team and a very competitive team. And I'm here to compete for my spot as well.
All right, we'll go to Jose Gudino on Zoom. Jose, go ahead.
¿Qué tal, Jairo? José Gudino, Conexión Deportiva. Jairo, obviamente has dejado muy claro tu objetivo, ¿no? Llegar a esta liga para poder brincar a Europa. Siendo un año mundialista y pese a que realmente no ha sido parte de este ciclo con la selección, ¿no? ¿Aún sueñas con llegar, tener una buena actuación con el Payo y llegar a colarte al mundial? ¿O ya tu objetivo sería para el próximo ciclo buscando ser con la selección para el próximo mundial, para el 26?
Pues mis objetivos son, pues como dicen, ¿no? Nunca digas nunca. La verdad yo me sigo preparando para poder estar en la selección. Este es un paso muy importante para mí. Y la verdad no descarto la posibilidad de poder ir al mundial, ¿no? Del 2022. Porque espero hacer muy buenas actuaciones aquí en Chicago para que me volteen a ver y pues dar todo para ver si me puedo colar a este Mundial de Qatar y si no, igual dar mi mejor esfuerzo para poder estar seleccionado y considerado para el siguiente Mundial.
You've made your objective really clear, to come to this team and play really well and hopefully make a jump somewhere else. But with that in mind and it being a World Cup year, are you hoping to make the World Cup this year with the national team, or are you thinking maybe you play very well and look forward to 2026? My goals are, well, never say never. I'm here, I'm keep preparing myself to hopefully be called up to the national team once again. But for me, it's very important. It's a big step in my career, and I haven't given up on the possibility of going to the World Cup with Mexico in 2022. So I'm going to be here. I'm going to keep getting ready. And I'm going to give everything that I have here in Chicago so that people can turn and look at me, and hopefully I can, you know, tag along onto that World Cup team. But if not, then I'm going to stay concentrated and stay focused, and hopefully, you know, catch the eye of the Mexican national team once again, and keep an eye on 2026.
Hernan, go ahead.
Hey, my question is for Sebastian and Ezra from an Exclusive magazine. Sebastian, 8 years ago, maybe I would ask this question, that the Fire was looking for players with not a jersey and a nationality. How important is to bring this Mexican young player, and were you guys looking for more into the scouting in Mexico for more players like this kind? And for Nesra, it's how was the reaction of the teammates when Jairo has his first practice today? Thank you.
Yeah, of course it is important. We know the importance of Mexican players in Chicago. I think there was always questions everybody was asking, when is the first Mexican player coming? You have a massive Mexican community here. We'd like to serve this community as well. And it was hard work to bring Jairo here to Chicago, but finally we made it. And I mean, that's the start. We have also a lot of American Mexican boys within our group, with Mauricio Pineda, with Brian Gutierrez, and the youngsters as well. And I think it's also a good combination. It's not just looking for different countries, is also a good, finding a good combination how we can contribute to the community of Chicago.
Well, we have a very good group of guys, very tight-knit unit, so it was easy for him to fit in, and you can see from the first day, you know, laughing and joking with some of his teammates and stuff, so that was good to see. A lot of them are his age or even younger, so you know, with his experience and stuff, he'll help a lot. But as far as getting along with the teammates, it went really, really well today. And when you have that kind of quality, players kind of gravitate towards you. So it was good, the first day.
All right, we'll do one more from Brian Sandalo on Zoom. Go ahead, Brian.
Sure. This is for Jairo and Sebastian. Jairo, you talked about wanting to go on to Europe eventually. Why do you think that coming to the Fire, a team that frankly has struggled most of the last 13 years, is a better place for you to use a platform than Atlas, one of the best teams in Mexico? And then for Sebastian, what was the selling point to Jairo that this was indeed a better career move for him than Atlas or maybe some other team elsewhere?
Ya hablaste de que tu objetivo es venir al Fire y desempeñarte bien y hacer el salto a Europa. ¿Por qué pensaste que venir a Chicago, un equipo que francamente ha batallado un poco en los últimos años, es una mejor plataforma para ti para ser visto, para hacer ese salto, que Atlas, que es uno de los mejores equipos de México en el momento?
Porque esta liga es muy vista, ¿no? Es muy vista allá porque me lo han dicho. También porque en Atlas igual pasamos momentos difíciles, ahorita actualmente son de los mejores equipos de México y por eso también me puse ese reto, ¿no? para poder hacer las cosas que hice en Atlas para que este club también salga adelante como lo hice allá.
This league is very well watched. They watch it a lot in Europe. I know that because they've told me. And also here because even in Atlas, we've gone through some very bad times. And right now, we're going through a really good time. And it's going through one of its best moments. And so I put it upon myself as one of my goals to come here and do good things here and basically do the things here that I did over there.
Hi, Brian. It was more about how we would integrate him into our team and how our coaches would love to have him in his in their team. Of course, it's about having Chicago is Chicago, and that's not to underestimate. We have all the Mexicans over here. It's also one point. But more or less, it was also a sportive decision. The league is getting better and better, and we feel it ourselves. It's every year it gets more competitive, and also the Europeans, they see it now as a better league. It's growing, and you see also the number of transfers being made in the past. They speak for themselves, and that's why it is an attractive league to come, maybe before a step going to Europe.
All right, apologies, we do have a couple more questions. We'll take one from Jorge Trujillo on Zoom, and then we'll end here with Jeremy in the room. Jorge, go ahead.
Jairo, gracias a todos. La afición de Chicago Jairo, aquí la afición de Chicago Fire, está creciendo temporada, es cada vez más exigente y están desesperados de ver al equipo nuevamente campeón. A pesar de estos jugadores o grandes jugadores mexicanos que estuvieron aquí, o incluso uno de talla mundial como Parkinson Steiger, pues el equipo ha quedado corto, ¿no? Con toda esta presión a cuestas, ¿qué se puede esperar o qué puede esperar la afición de ti en tu llegada aquí al equipo?
Que yo hablo por mí, voy a dar todo mi mayor esfuerzo, toda mi dedicación y mi profesionalismo hacia el equipo para que el equipo pueda salir de esa situación, ¿no? De esa presión de que cada vez la gente está haciendo más aparte. Yo como mexicano, yo sé cómo se siente un mexicano también en esas instancias de que tu equipo va mal, pero espero cambiar eso junto con todos mis compañeros, porque si ves el equipo es un gran equipo, tiene jugadores muy buenos y la verdad vengo a sumar y a aportar mucho al equipo.
The fan base here in Chicago has been growing, and every year they're getting more and more, they're demanding more and more from the club. And even despite having great players, even World Cup players like Bastian Schweinsteiger, they haven't really had the greatest result. With this in mind and the growing desperation of the fan base, what can they expect from you here? I speak only for myself. I know I'm going to give the best of myself, all of my dedication, all of my professionalism to come to this team and be able to look forward and move ahead. And also, as a Mexican, I know how it feels for a Mexican when your team is doing poorly. So I think that my team, with me and all of my teammates, we're going to work hard to change that, because they're really good players. We have a really good quality team here. And so I'm actually here to just add to it and to work with everyone to get better.
Great, we'll take one last one here in the front from Jeremy.
Sebastian, what aspects of Jairo's game in particular stood out to you and made him someone you wanted to bring to the club?
Well, Ezra pointed out before the technical ability. When I saw him live, it was even better than on the screen, and I was very impressed with his skills offensively, and also the commitment that he has for his team, working hard defensively as well as a group. And look, we are ambitious. We want to be successful and to have a player with a full commitment for the team effort. That is what you need. And Jairo stood out with many things, and that was one of it.
Great. All right. Thanks, everyone. That'll end the Q&A portion of today's press conference. We'll have a quick photo op with all three gentlemen on the stage. So if you guys just hang back for that, we'll knock that out really quickly.
This is Larry Hawley joining you again here as we have live coverage of Jairo Torres' news conference from downtown Chicago here on WGN News Now. Torres comes to Chicago after a very long and productive stay in Liga MX with Atlas FC. He actually just played his last match there on April 30th and actually scored a goal. We're looking at a photo opportunity here with manager Ezra Hendrickson, technical director Sebastian Pelzer, Big day for the Fire. We saw a few months ago with them acquiring Jardon Shaqiri, how important that was to the club, and what it meant just to the fan base to have a major name coming to Chicago. This is another one of those moves. The Fire getting a prominent player from Mexico. You heard Torres speak a number of times about how important it was to be a Mexican player here with the Chicago Fire. He recognizes the history to which the club has had when it comes to those natives of Mexico who have played with the team before, and certainly excited to try to help elevate the franchise. You heard him in that last quote speak about how difficult it has been, and he understands how difficult it has been for the club as they've tried to find success but haven't really been able to do it. Even with World Cup players like Bastian Schweinsteiger, who joined the club in 2017, they were able to make the playoffs that year, but not much sustained success after that. Torres is hoping to change that. You heard throughout the news conference how he is 100% committed to Major League Soccer, the Chicago Fire, and as he mentioned, Atlas FC may be going for another championship in Liga MX this year, that he still feels very committed to the Chicago Fire and doing the best that he can now as he has a 3-year contract with the club. Now, we mentioned what Torres can do on the field. And I think the biggest thing is give the Chicago Fire FC a scoring punch, which frankly has been lacking for the last few years. And even last game this season, so far the Fire have only scored 6 goals. Their only score on Saturday in a loss to New York Red Bulls came on a penalty kick. In fact, Shaqiri's only 2 goals so far have come on penalty kicks, which isn't a bad thing. He's converting them, but the Fire are still looking for more chances. And you have to figure, at least at this point, that you could see Torres really being able to help that. You heard in the news conference manager Ezra Hendrickson saying that Torres indeed will have the chance to play some minutes against Atlanta United FC on Saturday when the club hits the road to go to Atlanta. That's a little bit of a change of plans. Initially, it was expected that Torres was going to make his debut in the May 14th match at Soldier Field against FC Cincinnati, one you could see at 7 p.m. on WGN TV Channel 9. Looks like those plans have changed, and Torres is going to get the chance to sign up. Again, we talked before about the importance of having Torres here and what it means to a fan base that is looking for the club to really take that next step forward. Remember, they've not had a lot of success since 2012. Only that 2017 playoff appearance has come there. The Fire tried to start over in 2020. New owner, Joe Mansueto, new manager Rafael Wicky came in with a whole new group of players, didn't really work out. The Fire in the shortened 2020 season came awfully close to making the postseason, but remember, they expanded that postseason because of the pandemic, so a few more teams got in than usual. Had it been a normal year, they probably would have been out of the running, and that was certainly the case in 2021. The Fire were out of the running pretty much from about June on. They never were really able to recover. Rafael Wicky was fired in August. Frank Klopas, the longtime assistant and still assistant for Chicago Fire FC, took over after that. But Torres is one of those big-name players coming from Liga MX, coming from Atlas FC, has had success in that league, and is one of those players that can really make an impact, especially when it comes to the Fire and scoring. Now, so far this year, he's played in 38 matches. He has 3 goals and 4 assists for Atlas FC. They're once again a championship competitive team, and he's had, again, another great run for a player trying to find a way to come to Chicago and finally help the Fire break through, because let's face it, folks, it's been a rough decade for the club, and hopefully at some point they'll be able to figure out. Now, I had this picture in particular up here because Torres scored a goal in his final Atlas FC game on Saturday, and you can see his teammates lifting him up in support. Obviously, what they lose, the Fire gain, and it's going to be a big moment when he does make his debut for the Fire this Saturday, and of course, at home against FC Cincinnati on May 14th. Let's go ahead and take a look at some of Torres' soccer resume. We've mentioned a couple times, played with Atlas FC of Liga MX since 2016. It is a 3-year contract with the Fire, so he's through 2025. Mentioned 3 goals, 4 assists this season. Now, you also heard in the news conference that Torres has talked about playing for the Mexican national team and how much that would mean for him. Well, he has taken part in U-17, U-22, and he did make an appearance with the senior team. Chances of him being able to make the squad in 2022, he kind of floated it out there. Seemed like he was very, very focused on 2026, perhaps representing his home country in the Olympics. But for right now, he is here with the Chicago Fire, hoping that he can help them make a playoff push and get into the postseason for the first time in 5 years. Maybe it's a theme with Chicago teams. The Bulls made the playoffs for the first time since 2017 this year. Maybe the Fire can do the same. They have a little bit of work to do right now, though. The club right now sitting outside of the playoff picture in their roughest stretch of the year. They lost in the U.S. Open Cup opener to USL League One side Omaha. And they lost that, and then on that Tuesday, and then the following Saturday, they lost to Minnesota United 3-0 in their most decisive defeat. This weekend, they had a 1-0 lead going into the half, had it through the 70th minute, but would surrender two goals and lose that one 2-1. So the Fire on a two-game losing streak right now in MLS, hoping maybe Torres can provide a spark, and he'll get the chance to this Saturday. Well, we thank you very much for tuning into this live coverage here on WGN News Now of Jairo Torres making his debut with Chicago Fire FC. He does so at a press conference and is expected to this Saturday against Atlanta United FC. But for now, I'm Larry Hawley. Thank you so much for watching. We appreciate it and have a wonderful day.